Match game 74, production number 0278, take one.
Get ready to match the star. Donald Ross. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Patty Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Now, you remember last time we were together?
Yes.
Sandy and her dog were lost in the forest. And now we have to figure out where we go from there, right?
Without Johnny Yule Gibbons?
What's that?
Without Yule Gibbons?
Without Yule Gibbons.
And not with an Italian accent?
That's right. With just straight. That. Charles, you're writing already, and I haven't even asked a question yet.
Just a few Christmas cards.
Oh, all right. Let's say hello to our two players, Janet Finn and Ninfa Jarvis.
How are you?
This lady has a total of $7,150 to her credit. And, I don't know, money relaxes me, but she gets more tense the more money she wins there. Would you take a deep breath? What can we do to relax her? Is there anything we could do to relax her?
Yes, I'd like to borrow her money.
She is very tense. She fell down at Disneyland last week. 8 people rode her.
No. All right, she's being challenged by Ninfa, who scored 2 in her first round question. She scored 3 over here, Janet did. And we'll pick it up with round 2. But first, we've got to pick up on this message. Bet. All right, push the button, reveal our second round questions, and ask Ninfa, our challenger, to make a selection.
Let's try B.
B. Now, last time, Ninfa, you matched Donald and Charles. The 2 of you lay out, and the rest of you will do this.
No, do you do it this way?
The woman is rude.
Yes. But soft, right. But soft. What light? No. Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth. Yep. Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth.
I haven't finished writing to my friend Lucille Callan yet, so I'll have to hurry up.
You write a little answer for us, if you would please, madam. Okay. Everybody's ready, Ninfa. Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth.
I think he lost his suit.
His suit.
Yeah.
She say, lady with the pretty first name, Ninfa, lost his suit in a telephone booth. Just kidding.
Oh, am I first?
You're first.
Oh, the man with the suit and the tie and the funny stuff.
Yeah.
Oh.
He doesn't participate.
Well, he had his suit, but he dropped his glasses.
Lost his glasses. Okay, that's a possible answer. Not a bad one at all. All right, she's looking for suit. Hello there.
Oh, me?
You play.
Oh, hello.
Right.
Okay. Oh.
Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth.
Yes.
Lost his...
Lost his S.
His S. Okay.
Which, if done with the Jewish accent, has a
You went to college, eh?
That's
okay.
Right.
All right, Richard.
Okay. Actually, on this game, you should have said lost his burrow. I happen to know that Clark Kent, isn't that the
gentleman? Yes, Clark Kent was Superman.
Very noble person.
Yes.
Very pure.
Yes, indeed.
And then he met the dreaded Lola Lee.
Yes.
And I'm sorry to say, lost his virtue.
Lost his virtue. In a telephone booth.
Long distance.
Yes.
Collect.
Oh, what a sight it was.
He enjoyed every moment.
You've got to match Fanny to stay in the game. Now, she's looking for the answer suit, Fanny.
Yes, I'd like to talk to the referee, because I have something I think might match. It's clothes.
Clothes?
And
that does match. All right. You got a reprieve there, and at this moment we have a tie. She has to have her second round question, though, and we'll see if we break the tie. Now, one match will win the game for you, Janet. Last time you matched Fanny, Richard, well, the whole lower tier.
Cell block now... 11 will end.
Cell block 11.
Why does this kid have a custodian?
This is that's the one over there.
I want to hear more about Little Orphan Annie and Fanny.
This is for the dingbats only.
Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. I'm sick and tired of going to the drive-in movies on a blank. Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. Did you hear that, Janet? Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. I'm sick and tired of going to the drive-in movies on a blank. All right, how we doing?
I bought Fanny Fag a present.
You don't even have dark roots.
This girl's a real redhead.
I bought Fanny Flag a present, and she hasn't worn it all week, and I'm in tears.
She will. No, give her a chance. All right, Janet, are you ready? Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. I'm sick and tired of going to the drive-in movies on a blank.
On a horse?
On a horse. Okay. One horse. We'll win the game.
Have you ever tried to say Nympha Jarvis and Janet Finn three times very quickly?
Nympha Jarvis, Janet Finn. Nympha Jarvis, Janet Finn.
One
Nympha
more
Jarvis,
time.
Nympha Jarvis, Janet Finn.
In lieu of that, I said cow.
Cow.
Well, he's a farmer.
All right. One horse wins a game, Brett.
I'm almost absolutely... I cannot tell you how I hate those shirts.
And ties.
And ties, matching. I no wonder she hates him. I think this is a match, and I don't want any argument.
We'll be the judge of that.
Jackass.
No, that's not a horse.
It has four legs, and you ride it.
Yeah, but that's not a horse. You know, used to do that to Jack Klugman, too. And what is he? Is he a horse?
No, he was a jackass. No.
Charles, one horse wins a game.
She still remains a
cow. Look at this. We got a tie here. You really did get a reprieve. Three to three. I'll tell you what happens when we have a tie right after I tell you about these messages. Here we go. Now, when we have a tie like this, we just say Shazam, and the board gets wiped clean, and I push this button here and reveal the thing that says tie here. Isn't that clever? Somebody thought this out. And one question for each contestant here, and the one who scored the most will be the winner. Nympha, would you make a selection?
Let's try A this time.
You want A. She had B last time. Now she wants A. The Texan said to his butler,
I've invited 200 people for a cocktail, so you better mix the martinis in the blank. This here Texan said, I've invited 200 people for cocktails. You better mix the martinis in the blank.
What the heck did he mean by that?
Well, I don't know, but you know how those... Did you write something?
Oh, yeah. I do myself.
How come you keep forgetting that? You must be dumb.
Dumber than a heifer and wiener.
You got two more of those shirts, have you?
Two more. And I have actually six.
You have
in
six.
In case one of the shows didn't work out.
All righty, Nympha. The Texan said to his butler, I've invited 200 people for cocktails. You better mix some martinis in the blank.
In the bathtub.
Oh! There's a degree of appropriateness to that because gin is an ingredient of martinis and bathtub gin.
You're making my mouth water.
That's right. Donald?
No. Texan is richer than her Texan. I had him mixed in the swimming pool.
In the swimming pool! Yeah. Oh, that's good, Donald. Brett?
Well, you know, I know a lot of Texans, and they are the rich. And the Texans I know are just so rich.
They are.
They're just so wealthy, and they always mix their martinis in the swimming pool.
Ooh, that's two swimming pools. All right, Charles.
I said in the oil well.
In the oil well. Well, I mean, that's rich. Yes, sir. Hello there, little girl.
How do?
Would you like a martini?
Say hey.
In the swim pool. Okay. Well, sir, so far, we don't have a bathtub.
Neither do I.
You do those accents.
Now, show that card.
There.
No.
You didn't say show the other way.
Show the other way.
Son, we always mix them in the pool.
In the pool? Is that way we do it? That's right. All right. Now, this lady talks Texas talk.
Hi, and a hello to you, honey.
Yes.
You know, you have never been to Texas because we mix them in the pool.
In the pool. Five pools there, Ninfa.
I missed the 200.
Yep. Okay, now, Janet, you need one match to win the game. This is for you. Listen carefully. The nurse said to the doctor, I know it's none of my business, but I really don't think it's right to give your girlfriend a free blank for her birthday. The nurse said that. Said that to the doctor. Everybody plays. No, that's not what he said. He didn't say everybody plays. What he said was.
What he said was everybody out of the pool.
No, he said. Yeah, everybody out of the pool because there's a lot of martinis in that pool. No, the nurse said to the doctor, I know it's none of my business, but I really don't think it's right to give your girlfriend a free blank for her birthday. Why are you all staring at me? You should be writing something.
I don't understand that question.
I am a veteran, and I understand the question.
Attaboy. Attaboy. Take a cue from Donald there. Look how quick he finished there. It's none of my business.
How does he know anybody would wear those shirts in that tie?
All right, Charles.
Go ahead.
I know it's none of my business, but I really don't think it's right to give your girlfriend a free blank for her birthday. You see?
I think Charles
Don't touch me unless you love me, Richard.
Charles has just had a
You
stroke.
Do love me. Oh, that's fine.
Yes.
Has anyone ever told you that you have very lovely hands?
Anyone ever told you you have very lovely hands?
How can you see his hands looking down his throat? Oh, you're finished, Charles. We're just doing our old vaudeville act here while you're ready. All right. Janet Finn, the nurse said to the doctor, I know it's none of my business, but I really don't think it's right to give your girlfriend a free blank for her birthday.
Examination.
A free examination? For who? You know, this could be a very interesting game.
Yeah.
Then again?
I mean, based on her answer. Well, we'll find out. Donald, what did you say?
His girlfriend was a little sicker, I think, than Janet's girlfriend. I had an operation.
A free operation.
Yeah.
Yep. All right, Brett.
I was going more for the needle.
Really?
I said shot.
A free shot. Yeah. All right, Charles.
You know what a free shot is, don't you, Charles?
Gosh, it's just a non sequitur, Charles. She means nothing by it. Non sequitur. That's it.
Very sweet.
You sit down. It's my show. Get your own show if you want to holler at her. I'm the only one allowed to holler at her.
I can't be here next week. I think I'm going to go to another show. No, I said never. Physical.
A free physical examination that wins the game. What do you got there? Examination, operation, facelift. Okay. There's another 100 for you. Okay. Well, Ninfa, I'm sorry to say goodbye to you.
Thank you.
Well, I'm glad you had a good time. We certainly enjoyed meeting Ninfa Jarvis with a pretty first name. A gift for you backstage. Thank you, Ninfa.
Bye.
Goodbye. All right. Ready? We're going to do this right after we have this commercial. Okay? All right. Hello there, friends. Are you ready? Okay. Well, I'm not. No, I am. We're going to have another go. This is your fifth time you've had a go at the big money here. You're up to $7,250. Got a chance at over $5,000 here. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Mountain blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. The next one, $250. And the third, $100. All right, which celebrities would you like some help from?
Richard, please.
Richard, please.
Mountain climber.
Mountain climber. There's one for you.
Charles?
Mountain greenery.
Mountain greenery. Okay. It's a famous old song.
Brett, how about mountaintop?
Mountaintop. So, now, Janet, you have mountaintop, mountain greenery, and mountain climber. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. Think it over and then tell us what your decision is.
Mountain dew.
Mountain dew.
Mountain what?
Mountain Dew,
she said.
It's a California wine, isn't it?
Mountain Dew. What's Mountain that? Some Dew. Kind of intoxicating liquor or something like that?
It's green pop.
It's green pop, all right. Okay, Mountain Dew is what she's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response? Mountain Goat is a good answer.
Oh, good gravy. They had a strange group here
that's
that
right.
day.
Okay, looking for Mountain Dew. That's her decision. She's on her own. She didn't take any of the celebrity answers. Let's find out if it's under the $250 response. Mountain Dew it is! Good girl! Listen, since none of them gave you the answer... Since none of them gave you the answer and you don't have anybody to kiss, why, what the heck? Okay. What do you think is under there up another $500 one, audience? Mountain Top.
Greenery.
They say it's your answer, Brett. Mountain Top. Here's a $500 response. Mountain Top was right. Brett was right on that one. Okay. Now, Jenna.
Imagine that.
You're up to an even $7,500. You're going to try for an additional $2,500 now by matching one celebrity head-to-head.
Charles, please.
Charles.
Oh,
ready?
Oh, dear. She's so sweet to come back to me.
Yes. Okay.
She's going to leave very quickly, though.
She's... Ready? Rocket blank. Rocket blank. R-O-C-K-E-T blank. He has finished. Now, what answer would you suggest would match Charles Nelson Reilly? Rocket?
Ship.
Ship. Well, the audience likes that answer, Janet. The audience likes that answer. And Charles, for
we
2000...
We didn't get Moonlight Bay, but we went above it in our rocket... Oh!
For that money, didn't you?
Oh, yeah.
Have you got it all spent already in your mind?
We're going to get 3 sets of braces. We're going to add a bedroom. And
you're going to add a bedroom to your house?
A bedroom. And...
Would you like another husband?
You can afford it.
Yes,
Janet, you have how many children?
5.
And you look after?
4
more. You look after 9 children altogether, right?
Yeah.
Well, then that's lovely that you
Yes, want. Indeed. Okay, now let's meet another player. Here comes Pat Davenport. Hello there, Pat. Careful. Whoops. You know Janet Finn, Pat?
Yes.
How are you, Pat Davenport? And tell
Fine,
us about yourself.
You. I'm from Huntington Beach. I have 3 children. I'm a schoolgirl, and I love the horses.
Now, wait a minute. What does it mean you're a schoolgirl?
I'm going to junior college.
Oh, and what are you studying?
Business.
Monkey business?
Man,
there's a girl majoring in monkey business. How about that?
That's what I majored in, honey.
Business administration.
But you're a school girl.
Okay, well, that's very good. Now, we've got a... I wish you could see this. The stage manager is saying, which is a TV signal that means hurry up. And the producer is standing to her left about 5 feet saying...
He has chewing gum on his hands.
He has chewing gum on his hands. That's what he's giving that for. Okay, ladies, you gotta stand by because we gotta do a little business with America, and this is it. Hello. We gotta quit now. Hasn't it been exciting so far, Pat?
Wonderful.
Well, you have a chance to have a go at it in a little while, and you'll have a chance to pull your body and soul together here. And,
yeah. I can have another baby. I can afford it.
I
like to chip in a couple of dollars.
Now listen to me, all right. Not here, you're not going to have another baby, I'll tell you that right. I'm going to step over here, maybe.
Oh, sure. She should be on the Price is Right.
To get a hearing aid. I missed all of
them. No, she said, you know, I can have another baby. She's won so much money and all that. She's,
Don't do that!
No!
I love you, Gene.
Say goodnight. Say goodnight, Gene. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Goodbye. Join us next time.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Hudson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattle Tales next over most of these CBS stations.
Bet. All right. Push the button. Reveal our second round questions and ask Ninfa, our challenger, to make a selection.
Let's try B.
B. Now, last time, Ninfa, you matched Donald and Charles. The two of you lay out, and the rest of you will do this.
No, do you do it this way?
The woman is rude.
Yes. But soft, right. But soft. What light? No. Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth. Yep. Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth.
I haven't finished writing to my friend Lucille Callan yet, so I'll have to hurry up.
You write a little answer for us, if you would please, madam. Okay. Everybody's ready, Ninfa. Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth.
I think he lost his suit.
His suit.
Yeah.
All right. She say, lady with the pretty first name, Ninfa, lost his suit in a Ninfa telephone booth. Just kidding.
Oh, my first?
You're first.
Oh, the man with the suit and the tie and the funny stuff.
He doesn't participate.
Well, he had his suit, but he dropped his glasses.
Lost his glasses. Okay, that's a possible answer. Not a bad one at all. All right, she's looking for a suit. Hello there.
Oh, me?
You play.
Oh, hello.
Right.
Okay. Oh.
Superman lost his blank in a telephone booth.
Yes.
Lost
his S.
His S. Okay.
Which, if done with the Jewish accent, has a
yes,
whole
I know.
Other meaning.
Yes, I know. You went to college, eh?
That's
okay.
Right.
All right, Richard.
Okay. Actually, I'm...
Match Game 74, production number 0278, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Donald Ross. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Patty Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn!
Now, you remember last time we were together?
Yes.
Sandy and her dog were lost in the forest. And now we have to figure out where we go from there, right?
Without Johnny Yule Gibbons?
What's that?
Without Yule Gibbons?
Without Yule Gibbons.
And not with an Italian accent?
That's right. With just straight. Charles, well, you're writing already, and I haven't even asked a question yet.
Just a few Christmas cards.
Oh, all right. Let's say hello to our two players, Janet Finn and Ninfa Jarvis.
How are you?
This lady has a total of $7,150 to her credit. And, I don't know, money relaxes me, but she gets more tense the more money she wins there. Would you take a deep breath? What can we do to relax her? Is there anything we could do to relax her?
Yes, I'd like to borrow her money.
She is very tense. She fell down at Disneyland last week. 8 people rode her.
No. All right, she's being challenged by Ninfa, who scored 2 in her first round question. She scored 3 over here, Janet did. And we'll pick it up with round 2. But first, we've got to pick up on this mess.
So, did you write something?
Oh, yeah. I do myself.
How come you keep forgetting that? You must be dumb.
Dumber than a heifer and wiener.
You got 2 more of those shirts, have you?
2 more.
2 more.
And I have actually 6.
You have 6.
In case one of the shows didn't work out.
All righty. Ninfa, the Texan said to his butler, I've invited 200 people for cocktails. You better mix some martinis in the blank.
The bathtub.
In the bathtub. There's a degree of appropriateness to that because gin is an ingredient of martinis and bathtub gin. Hello there,
Donald. Oh, stop that. You're making my mouth water.
That's right. Donald?
No. Texan is richer than her Texan. I had him mixed in the swimming pool.
In the swimming pool. Yeah. Oh, that's good, Donald. Brett?
Well, you know, I know a lot of Texans, and they are the rich. And the Texans I know are just so rich.
They are.
They're just so wealthy, and they always mix their martinis in the swimming pool.
Ooh, that's 2 swimming pools. All right, Charles.
I said in the oil well.
In the oil well. Well, I mean, that's rich. Yes, sir. Hello there, little girl.
How do?
Would you like a martini?
Say hey.
Say hey.
In the swim pool.
In the swim pool. Okay. Well, sir, so far, we don't have a bathtub.
Neither do I.
I love it when you do those accents.
Now, show that card.
There.
No,
you didn't say show the other way.
Show the other way.
Son, we always mix them in the pool.
In the pool? Is that where we do it? That's right. All right. Now, this lady talks Texas talk.
Hi, and a hello to you, honey.
In movies on a blank.
On a horse?
On a horse. Okay. One horse will win the game.
Have you ever tried to say Ninfa Jarvis and Janet Finn 3 times very quickly?
Ninfa Jarvis, Janet Finn. Ninfa Jarvis, Janet Finn.
One
Ninfa
more
Jarvis,
time.
Janet Finn. Okay.
Yes. In lieu of that, I said cow.
Cow.
Well, he's a farmer.
All right. One horse wins a game, Brett.
I'm almost absolutely... I cannot tell you how I hate those shirts.
And ties.
And ties, matching. I no wonder she hates him. I think this is a match. And I don't want any argument.
We'll be the judge of that.
Jackass.
No, that's not a horse.
It has 4 legs and you ride it.
Yeah, but that's not a horse. You know, used to do that to Jack Klugman, too. And what is he? Is he a horse?
No, he was a jackass.
Charles, one horse wins a game.
She still remains at the
cow.
Ooh,
look at this. We got a tie here. You really did get a reprieve. 3-3. I'll tell you what happens when we have a tie right after I tell you about these messages. Here we go. Now, when we have a tie like this, we just say Shazam, and the board gets wiped clean, and I push this button here, and reveal the thing that says tie here. Isn't that clever? That somebody thought this out. And one question for each contestant here, and the one who scored the most will be the winner. Ninfa, would you make a selection?
Let's try A this time.
You want A. She had B last time. Now she wants A. The Texan said to his butler,
I've invited 200 people for a cocktail, so you better mix the martinis in the blank. This here Texan said, I've invited 200 people for cocktails. You better mix some martinis in the blank.
What the heck did he mean by that?
Well, I don't know, but you know how...
In this game, you should have said lost his burrow. I happen to know that Clark Kent, isn't that the
guy? Yes, Clark Kent was Superman.
Very noble person.
Yes.
Very pure.
Yes, indeed.
And then he met the dreaded Lola Lee.
Yes.
And I'm sorry to say lost his virtue.
Lost his virtue. In a telephone booth.
Long distance.
Yes.
Collect.
Oh, what a sight it was.
We enjoyed every moment.
You've got to match Fanny to stay in the game. Now, she's looking for the answer suit, Fanny.
Yes, I'd like to talk to the referee because I have something I think might match. It's clothes.
Clothes? And that does match.
We got a reprieve there, and at this moment we have a tie. She has to have her second round question, though, and we'll see if we break the tie. Now, one match will win the game for you, Janet. Last time you matched Fanny, Richard, well, the whole lower tier.
Cell block now... 11 will end.
Cell block 11.
Okay. To have a custodian.
This is that's the one over there.
I want to hear more about Little Orphan Annie and Fanny.
This is for the dingbats only.
Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. I'm sick and tired of going to the drive-in movies on a blank. Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. Did you hear that, Janet? Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. I'm sick and tired of going to the drive-in movies on a blank. All right, how we doing?
I bought Fanny Fag a present.
You don't even have dark roots.
This girl's a real redhead.
I bought Fanny Flag a present, and she hasn't worn it all week, and
she will.
Tears.
She will. No, give her a chance. All right, Janet, are you ready? Stephanie said, I'm not dating Farmer John anymore until he gets a car. I'm sick and tired of going to the drive.